Welcome to Senior to Junior Academy. So this is the fourth part of the series that we have continued, the top core companies campus interview questions with explanation. So in this part there will be only two questions. As you know that in earlier we had five questions, in this part we'll be having two questions, because in this video I'll be sharing the important topics like turbocharger and supercharger, and they are quite very important topics, so it will take quite time. So I have thought to just include two questions in this set. So we'll see these two questions of supercharger and turbocharger, which was asked in many of the companies like Tata Technology, it was asked in Sapurji, it was asked in Fiat also. So we will see what is supercharger and what is turbocharger in this lecture. So the first question was, what is supercharger? So before explaining supercharger, you must know what is natural aspirated engine. Natural aspirated engine. So natural aspirated engine is an engine in which air intake totally depends on the atmospheric pressure. Means there is no supercharger, there is no turbocharger that will force the air into the cylinder. So natural aspirated engine is the engine in which your vehicle takes air from atmospheric pressure without using turbocharger and supercharger. So in natural aspirated engine, as you can see, the air will come from this side and it will go to this side. So whatever power it generates, it will show. So let me tell you three kinds of power that are used in automobile engine. First one is your indicated power. Second one is your frictional power, and third one is your brake power. So let me explain you these three terms: indicated power, frictional power and brake power. See, indicated power is total power that your engine generates. For example, your engine generates 250 kilowatt of power. This is your indicated power. Now what is frictional power? Is like how much your power is wasted in friction. Like many things are there which causes to lose the amount of power, like frictional losses are there. So for example, like 150 is your frictional losses. I hope you are getting it. Like 250 is your indicated power. Indicated power is power that is totally generated power of the engine. Frictional power is the amount of power that is lost in friction. And brake power is the difference of the indicated power and frictional power. Your brake power, net brake power, will be 100 kilowatt. So I hope you got the meaning of indicated power, frictional power and brake power. So your net brake power will be 100, and this is the only power that is available to your shaft of your engine. The main output is your brake power. So now this was a brief introduction about natural aspirated engine. The reason of telling this brief introduction is because after this only you can understand supercharger. Now we'll see what is supercharger. See, in supercharger what happens is that, as I told you, that in natural aspirated engine you have no measures to bring that air into the cylinder. It comes automatically. Now in supercharger what happens is that you have a supercharger located here that allows the high density air into the cylinder, and because more air comes into the cylinder, more fuel burns and you get more power. So this is the use of your supercharger. As you know that as you go, like this is a mountain, and for example you are here, you are climbing up the mountain. What will happen? As you climb up the mountain, air density will become less, and more thinner and thinner air will be at the top of the side. So you will feel that you are not breathing properly. So same happens in case of vehicle also. As your vehicle is in the sea level, more air is there and it can easily breathe. But as you go up, the vehicle find difficult in taking air So it requires some element that will force the air into the cylinder. For that reason, we require supercharger and turbocharger. In the next question, I will see turbocharger. First, let us see what is supercharger. I hope you got what is supercharger. It is basically a device which forces the air into the cylinder so that more air can be reached into cylinder and more fuel is burnt and you get the more power. So this is the overview of supercharger, but the disadvantage is that though it produces power, like for example it produces 250 kilowatt of power, but the disadvantage is that in order to run this supercharger you need a belt from crankshaft that will be connected to a supercharger and that will rotate the compressor and air will be sucked inside it. So after all, it is used to produce power and again it is taking the power from engine only to run it. So for example, it produces 250 kilowatt of power and 50 kilowatt of power is being used from the engine to run the supercharger. So net output will be 200 kilowatt, and this is the one of the biggest disadvantage of supercharger, that it uses the power from engine to run itself. So net power you get is 200 kilowatt, and this is the concept behind supercharger. So let me just explain again. Supercharger is a device that forces the air into the cylinder in order to get more power, and the disadvantage is that it uses the power from the crankshaft of the engine to run itself. So that amount of power needs to be subtracted from the power generated and the net power you get is the output of the supercharger. So this is the disadvantage of supercharger. Now we will see our main device, that is turbocharger. What is turbocharger and why it is used? Ask in Tata Technology, Sapurji Palanji, Fiat, Tata Steel, maximum company has asked this term supercharger, and you need to understand this with full clarity so that if they ask you any question you need to answer that. So as I told you why we need supercharger and turbocharger, only the reason is because as the vehicle finds difficult to breathe, so they need some extra device that can power and push the air inside the cylinder. So we require turbocharger, and there are various advantages of using turbocharger. First one is your power improves, your fuel economy improves, and most importantly your emission decreases. So what is supercharger? Supercharger is an exhaust driven turbine connected to and driving a radial compressor. So we'll see in the next diagram. See, this is your turbocharger. So let me explain. Turbocharger is your basically, see, after combustion you get exhaust this side. That exhaust, in order to, like, if in a natural aspirated engine what we did here, we just wasted our exhaust gases. But after the invention of turbocharger, we found that the exhaust gas was very precious to us. So what the engineer did was that they utilized this exhaust gas. Like, this is the manifold of the exhaust system. When the exhaust gas comes here, they have fitted a turbine, and this turbine is mechanically connected to a compressor. So exhaust gas goes to the turbine and it pushes the turbine to rotate it. Now what happens is when this rotates, it is mechanically connected to a compressor, so this compressor also rotates. So what does the compressor do is that it sucks the air from the atmosphere and just pushes back to the intake manifold, and in the intake manifold again it goes to the intake port and into the cylinder. So as you can see, there is one device called intercooler. This is known as your intercooler. So what is the function of intercooler is that, like, you have the inlet, your inlet gas is coming, inlet air is coming from the compressor, so this is hot because it has been compressed, and you know that your hot gases will contain less density of oxygen. You know this relation, rho is equals to पी बाई आर टी। एज योर टेम्परेचर इज हाई योर डेंसिटी विल बी लो। सो वाट हैपेंस इज द एयर दैट कम्स इन दिस चैम्बर द टेम्परेचर इज हाई बिकॉज इट इज कंप्रेस्ड सो योर डेंसिटी इज लो हेयर एंड योर ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट इज लेस योर ओ टू कंटेंट इज लेस इन दिस साइड। So in order to increase the oxygen content so that more oxygen goes into the cylinder, we need to cool it. So we require an intercooler. I hope you got a clear idea what is turbocharger and how does it work. This is a turbine and you will be shocked to know that this turbine has a RPM of 1 to 1.6 lakh per minute. Means it rotates 1.6 lakh per minute. See, this is the power of the exhaust gas, and the exhaust gas which are done with which are not utilized or which have done their work are have to come out from this side. So this is the overall view of the turbocharger. You can see first one is your compressor inlet, then compressor discharge, then your third one is your intercooler, then your intake valve, then this is exhaust valve, then turbine valve, and this is 7-1 is your turbine discharge. So we'll see your why do we like, as I explained earlier, this is a just a schematic view of this. Your exhaust gas comes from here, then your inlet gas comes from here, air, and exhaust gas comes from here, and it rotates the turbine, which is mechanically connected to a compressor. It rotates the compressor, air is sucked into the cylinder, and this process continues. And here we get the total power, not unlike in the supercharger where we generated 250 kilowatt and 50 kilowatt we lost because of the belt connected to charge it. To run the supercharger, there was a belt connected to it. So we lost 50 kilowatt, but in these cases, we get full power, like 250 kilowatt. So this is the advantage of the turbocharger over supercharger. So we'll see a sectional view of turbocharger. As I told you that this is your turbine inlet, the exhaust gas goes from this side, this is a turbine, it rotates the turbine, and you can see this is mechanically connected to a compressor. This, when this compressor rotates, it takes air from the atmosphere and just pushes to the inlet cylinder. So the question is, the main question, if somebody asks, why do we need a turbocharger? As I told you that having turbocharger adds extra air. And what extra air means is that this is your cylinder, more air is going into the cylinder, more fuel will burn and more power you will get, and better combustion will happen. It will increase the power, it will improve fuel consumption, as amount of air and fuel ratio will be maintained in the turbocharger. It will improve your efficiency and altitude problem will be decreased. As I told you that in the mountain, if your vehicle is going, less air will be present in the top side of the mountain. So breathing problem will happen. But when you install turbocharger, this problem gets eliminated. So these are the pros of the turbocharger. The only disadvantage is the turbo lag. Turbo lag is the only disadvantage of this turbocharger. See, when I upload the next video in my IC engine lecture series, I have a separate series for IC engine. There I will explain you all the terms like turbo lag. There are many things like blow valve is there, wastegate turbocharger is there. So these terms are not required now for your interview. Just you need that why turbocharger is used and what is the function of turbocharger and what are the sectional view of turbocharger? What are the advantage of turbocharger over supercharger? I hope I have made all the things clear in this video. For that reason, I have uploaded only two questions. So, thank you for watching and please subscribe to this channel, Senior to Junior Academy, or you can join our group. So that I am telling you to join the group because there I upload a regular updates of all the examination and all the important questions for placement. So please subscribe the channel or join the group. Thank you for watching. Share knowledge, share success. All the best.